Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's take a look at accessing the dictionary built into your iPhone. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So did you know when you carry your iPhone around, you're also carrying around a whole dictionary, perhaps several of them? There's a dictionary built into your iPhone. But unfortunately, there's no dictionary app. You can't just launch an app and look up a word. But there are several ways to access all the definitions that are stored in your iPhone. And there are a few other ways to access dictionary definitions as well. So first, let's start off with the most obvious way to get to a dictionary definition. If you're in an app, like here in Safari, and you see a word and you want to get a definition for it, you can simply select it and then look for lookup. If you don't see it in the first set of commands, you can always use the arrows there to move around to see more. If you use look up, it'll look up the word. It'll actually do lots of different things, like give you suggested websites, Siri knowledge, all sorts of things. And the dictionary definition won't always be the very first one. It depends on the word. In this case, the thesaurus is first and then dictionary. You can tap on either one and you get the full dictionary definition in this case. So you can read about it, you get the pronunciation at the top, the example phrases, origin, the works. And yes, you also get a thesaurus in a lot of cases, and you could see other words that you can use instead. This is useful if you're writing. And in fact, you can use this in any app where you write as well. So here I am in the Notes app, but this would work in any other app like Pages, or when you're writing an email in the Mail app, or even in third-party apps where you write text. And you can select the text that you just wrote, and you could see, in this case, I need to go over to the next set of commands, and I can use lookup, and I get the same thing here. There's the thesaurus, there's the dictionary, and I get the full dictionary treatment. Now, if you want to look up a word without typing it first, you can do so using Spotlight Search. So just from the home screen or in many other locations, you can swipe down from the middle and you're in Spotlight Search, where you can search for all sorts of things like apps and such. But you can also type a word here. And if you don't see a dictionary definition appear, tap Show More Results. And then if you scroll down enough, you usually should find the dictionary definition somewhere. You can even tap Show More here, and we'll get thesaurus and dictionary in this section. And then you could go get to the dictionary definition for the word without ever having to type it or go into an app at all. Now, of course, you could also ask Siri. And if you ask Siri to define something, then you can go right to a definition and you won't get all those other suggestions, usually. And Siri is also really useful when you don't know how to spell a word and you're using the dictionary to learn how to spell it, or you want the definition but you still don't know how to spell the word. Define hypothesis.
Hypothesis means a supposition or proposed explanation made on the basis of limited evidence as a starting point for further investigation.
Not only do you get the definition on the screen, but Siri will speak it. So it could be really useful if you don't actually have your phone out, like you've got your AirPods in or something. Now, there are some settings for dictionary, even though there's no app. So go into the Settings app, and then it's under General. And go down to Dictionary. And then here, you'll get to select which dictionaries are included. So you saw how the thesaurus was always there. If I don't want to see that, I could turn that off really easily. Also, a dictionary of computer terms having to do with Apple is included in this Apple dictionary, and you can have that on or off. And there's a ton of other dictionaries in other languages, some of them translating from one language to another, some of them just showing definitions in that language. Now, of course, you're not restricted to using the dictionary that's built in. Just about any search engine has a dictionary built into it. So you can search using your default search engine, such as Google, and then you usually get the dictionary definition when you're just searching for a word. But it really does work in any search engine. So for instance, if I'm going to use DuckDuckGo instead, I could search for a word there, and I'll get a dictionary definition as well. Now, if you really do want to get a dedicated app with a dictionary in it, you can. Some of the major dictionaries have apps in the App Store. So for instance, here's Merriam-Webster, here's Oxford, and there are several others. So you can download one that you like. Here's the Webster dictionary I have on my iPhone, and it has a free version with ads, or you could subscribe. Other dictionaries will have different setups. So you could look up a word, you get its definition. It'll even allow you to tap on words inside the definition to jump to another definition. And you could speak the word instead of typing it if you don't know how to spell it. Supposition. So different apps are going to have different features, but you can just look in the App Store and see which one you like best. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.